everybody. How's everyone doing? Welcome back to my channel. I haven't filmed in a while. I've been kind of busy. I have family coming in, and then I'm traveling to Texas for a week to see my family, and I'm so freaking excited. I did color my hair, if you can tell. I did a purpley, burgundy-ish violet for fall. Kind of matches my shirt. If you guys don't know me, I pretty much dye my hair all the time. It's a different color all the time, and I'm pretty sure it's been every color out there besides blue. So today I'm going to do a fall get ready with me. I've been really excited to do a fall look, so I figured I would film it for you guys. I have some errands to run today, so I figured we could get ready together. I've been using this new product. It's the L'Oreal Paris Dermo Expertise Hydra Renewal. So I've been using this. Let's see if you can. I've been using this under my foundation. It says its claims is how to use. It's smoothly gentle. It's a smooth, gentle cream that you can use on your face throughout the day, or you can use it before you go to sleep, alone or under makeup. My face has been so dry lately, so I've been using this cream. And it doesn't have like a really bad smell or anything. And it's white, so you can't really see it. But my face has been feeling really good ever since I used it. So your foundation doesn't feel as drying. I know that my skin gets really dry in the winter, probably everyone's does, but I just feel like it just glides on a lot better, and I just kind of rub it on until it kind of, it gets like really, it gets really tacky. So it's like, it kind of just feels sticky. I feel like that's when you know it's like ready. And I just let that kind of set into my face for a little bit. And then I go in with the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. I'm almost out. I got this like in a little travel size thing. And it came with the Smashbox water too, and it's completely empty. I highly recommend the Smashbox primers, primer water, anything. I think that it works amazing. But before I go in with this, I'm gonna prime my eyes and give this cream like a little bit of time to just set in for a second. I'm gonna prime my eyes with the Tarte Shape Tape. It's in the shade Fair. I know you can't see that, but I have like a little ring light. And this is funny, you guys are probably gonna think this is funny. I'm actually filming with my MacBook. I just film with iMovie. I don't have a camera yet or anything like that. So that's what I film with. And my husband said he would get me a camera for Christmas. So we actually went and looked at them the other day, and I actually picked out the one I wanted. It wasn't even that pricey, surprisingly. And I did post on my channel the other, not my channel, I know you guys, some of y'all follow me on my Facebook makeup page, and if you haven't, it's just Katie Bates Makeup, and I post my videos on there as well. I asked you guys what y'all thought I should use as a backdrop. I'm filming in my guest room right now, so I want to get a backdrop, I want to get it looking pretty in here. Probably won't go all out like all the other YouTubers. It'll all be, you know, a work in progress. I'm sure once we buy our first home, I'll have like a room dedicated for that. Okay, so I have my eyes primed. And then I usually set it with the Wet n Wild Contour Palette Pit Pan on both sides. It's amazing. I don't know what it is about Wet n Wild, but they have seriously stepped up their game. And I just use the little e.l.f. brush. It's a highlighting brush, but I just use it to set my eye too. So I figured I would tell you guys a little bit about me. I'm sure most of my subscribers, which I don't have a lot right now, but I'm sure everybody knows about me that's subscribed to my channel. But I am a mom of twins. I have a boy and a girl. They were born last July on the 15th. And that is what I do. I'm a stay-at-home mom with my kids. And my husband just recently got out of the military. And, sorry, this shirt's kind of awkward. My husband just got out of the military, and now he's working at the new Hankook Tire Factory here in Clarksville, Tennessee. He likes it for the most part. He does work the night shift, so I'm pretty busy with my kids all day. I wish I could film more, but they're actually sleeping right now, so this is the time for me to get in here and film a video for you guys. So, that is what we're doing today. So I'm going to go in with the Tardius Pro Palette by Tarte. This has a lot of good shades for fall, especially this line. Not this one. This one right here. Yeah. This one has really good fall shades. So I'm going to go in with that palette today. So I'm going to start off with the... I'm going in with this brush, and I don't know, it says vintage on it. I don't know if these are good brushes or not. I do know they're synthetic, and I got them from Amazon. So I do have a set of Morphe brushes as well. I need to work on my brush collection, but I really like these brushes. I mean, they do really good. So I'm going to go in with the shade Innocent and use that as my transition shade. I'm not going to use tape today. I usually use tape, but I'm just not going to today. So I'm just throwing that all over my lid. And I really, really like that color. I think it's really pretty. A really good transition shade. I think that this Tardius palette, the eyeshadows are just so buttery. And they just go on so well. I've had this palette for almost a year already, and I barely made a dent in any of them. I just feel like it's worth the purchase. If you guys don't have it, you'll need to get it. It is awesome. Okay, so now that I have my transition shade in, I'm going to go in with the shade... What is this shade called? Oh, it's Edgy. The shade Edgy. And I'm going to use the same brush, and I'm going to throw that in to my crease area. Just like a really like smoked out brown color. You guys can hear my dog whining. He's outside the door. He wants to be in here with me, and I don't want him in here because he'll probably start barking. Okay, so now that I have both of those in my crease, I'm going to go in with more of like a pointier brush, and I'm going to go in with the shade, let's see, Drama, It's like a dark purpley burgundy. It kind of matches my hair. I'm going to move this camera to this side. So much better. I can see a lot better. Let me show you the shade that I'm using. It's this one right here. I kind of want like a vampy look. It's definitely going to be a little more dramatic for the type of errands that I'm running today, but it is what it is. I want to get this video up for you guys. I just want it to look very like whoosh, like smoked out. That's the goal that I'm going for. My eyebrows are terrible right now. I need to get my eyebrows done. Dog. Just ignore that. Really vampy and smoked out. Okay, and so now I'm going to grab the Jaclyn Hill palette. It's one of my favorites. And I'm going to go in with this maroon-ish brown shade. Let me see, I have the color right here. Let's see, this one is Chip. It's called Chip. Kind of a weird name for that type of color. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw it on my lid. And it's going to make it really, really smoked out and dark. Also, these shadows from the Jaclyn Hill palette, they're like effortless to blend out. They're great. I just love how smoky it is and just how fall and vampy it is. And I didn't even, usually when I do my lid, my eyeshadow on my lid, I'll spray it and dampen it a little bit, but I don't even need to with these shades. They're great. They're just so pretty. I just love them so much. So now that I have that packed on, I'm going to go back in with the Tardius palette, and I'm going to grab that Drama shade again, and I'm going to kind of just buff it out a little bit so there's no like harsh lines or anything. Nice and smoky. I really like it a lot. I feel like it makes my eyes look really green. Really, really like it. Okay, now my eyes are done, and we'll go on to the lower lash line here in a little bit. So for the top of my eyes, for my liner, I'm going to go in. Let me show you guys. It is the NYX Epic Ink Liner. I love the NYX eyeliner. It is amazing, and it's so pigmented, so black, and it dries really, really matte. Just really black, and I've gone through a lot of black eyeliners, and this one seems to be the best. We got our eyeliner done and our eyeshadow done. Just gonna fan it a little bit, let it dry. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with foundation, and of course I'm using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation in the shade Buff Bisque. It's light medium neutral. This foundation, I'm telling you guys, it's awesome. I just told my friend about it. She got it. She really likes it too. And I really like that it comes with a spatula. I'm going to go in and blend that out with my L'Oreal beauty sponge. On my face, and I just realized that I didn't go in with my Smashbox primer. But this foundation, luckily, doesn't make your pores. Like it blurs out your pores to me. So I won't really have a problem if I accidentally skip that step. Now that I have my foundation blended in, I'm gonna go in with the Naked, oh, it's backwards, I'm sorry. The Naked Weightless Concealer. It's in the shade Medium Light Warm. I haven't really wanted like a really bright under eye lately, so what I do is I go in with my Tarte Shape Tape after I apply this on, and I kind of just add that in just a little bit. I just haven't really wanted a bright like under eye. So then I have that on, and now I'm just gonna hit it with this too. Just a smidge. Not a lot. I'm gonna blend that in as well with this. The Naked Weightless Concealer. I know I talked about it in my other videos. It's just amazing. I love the Shape Tape, but it's very full coverage. And I just like a lighter concealer. And that's definitely my go-to. Just feel like it just looks like skin. I like it a lot. Just blend it up on your forehead. It's really, really, really pretty. Definitely covers up all the dark circles I have from being a mother. Just kidding. Sort of. So now I'm gonna go back in with the contour palette from Wet n Wild. And I'm going to set my under eye with this as well. I think it's really important to set your under eye, that way it doesn't crease throughout the day. My mom doesn't know this yet, but she's coming next week. And mom, if you're watching this, me and you are going to build a ring light together. I looked it up on YouTube, and it's really easy. And that's what we're going to do when you're here. Me and my mom usually craft when she comes. So we are going to build a ring light, and I'll definitely tell you guys about it. Because I have a little ring light right now. It's like this big. So that's what I have right now. I feel like it works. Most part. Okay, so now I'm going to go in and I'm going to set the rest of my face too before I bronze my face. And I'm just using this Morphe brush. There's no number on it. It's just a plain Jane little brush. I'm just going to go in and set the rest of my face. I don't mind being dewy and I don't mind being matte either. So set that. Okay. So now I'm going to go in with the Sony Akashic brush from Target. It's an awesome, awesome brush. And actually, I usually go in with that contour palette, but I'm actually going to use the Cheek Parade by Benefit. It comes with two blushes, a highlighter, and then two bronzing shades. And this one right here is what I'm going to go in and bronze with, and it's in the shade Hoola. It's just really pretty and just a really good overall bronzing shade. It's very natural looking. Bring it up on your forehead. I just think it's very, very, very pretty. And I will contour, like, get my like little shadow line with that Wet n Wild contour palette. But I just really am liking contouring with this Benefit palette right now. I just think it's really, really pretty. Definitely need to get some self-tanner. I completely ran out. Hit my nose with that a little bit. If I'm feeling really extra, I'll contour my nose. Okay, so now that I have that, I'm going to go in with this is the Japanesque, it's kind of like the knockoff, like, what is that brand called? Totally crossed my mind. NARS. Kind of like the NARS Eater brush. This is just the same thing, but cheaper. Kind of get that sharp line. And then I'm going to buff it out with this Soho brush. I don't know what kind of brush it is. It says face and eye and highlighter brush, but I like it for blending. Works really good. Alright, so now that we have that, my hair is wild. Now that we have that done, I am going to Really, really like that shade. It's awesome. Really pretty. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in and do my eyebrows. And what I've been using is the NYX Tame and Frame. And I've just been using this little angled brush. And it works really, really well. Okay, so now I have my brows and my lashes done. And I love these lashes. They are dramatic, but I'm obsessed, so I'm going to wear them. They're just so pretty. So pretty. Okay, so now I'm going to go in and do work on my waterline with the Maybelline Eye Studio in the shade Blackest Black. And I'm going to hit that in my waterline. Now that we have that in the waterline, let's go ahead and do the shadows that we did on top. We're going to smoke that out with our bottom lashes now. Just use like just a pencil brush or whatever brush you have that works for you. We're going to go back in with that Tardiest Pro. The first layer on, and then I'm going to go in with the darker shade now. Now we have our bottom line smoked out. I'm trying to hit this one by Wet n Wild. It's really, really pretty. It's kind of like a goldish color. And hit the Cupid's bow. Really, really. And for the blush, I'm going to go in with an oldie but a goodie. This e.l.f. It's just different types of blushes, whatever look you're going for. I'm going to actually go in with this one right here, the darkest one. Okay, and for lips, I'm going to go in with the NYX Soft Cream Pennsylvania. It's a dark one. So I'm going to apply this to my lips, and I will be right back. Okay, guys, so that is the final look. I really hope that you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed filming it for you guys. I really like my new hair color and this fall look. I just think it looks really, really good. I really, really like it. I really enjoy doing this makeup video for you guys. If you have not subscribed, please do so. tell your friends' friends, your family. I'm really hoping that I can get as many videos out for you guys as possible. So thanks for watching, and I will see you soon.